morning and a warm welcome to the first year batch to this inaugural ceremony of St. Anne's Arts and Science College, Madhavaram. With the blessings of God Almighty and the prayers of our beloved chairperson, Reverend Mother Lima Rosario, I deem it a privilege in welcoming the first year students who have joined us and have become a part of St. Anne's family. Pleasant greetings and a warm welcome by the Principal Dr. I. Annamal Arpudamary. A heartfelt welcome by the Dean of College Development, Srimati Benedict Kumari. And a sincere, hearty welcome by the teaching fraternity to our incoming batch of first years. We will start today's inaugural session with a prayer song.
Vinnanava Kaatranava Iraiva Odiyanava நீர்தானே உயிர்க்கெல்லாம் முதலானவன் நீர்தானே உயிர்க்கெல்லாம் முதலானவன் நான் தேடும் உலகெல்லாம் உறவானவன் ஜெகம் கூடி ஜதி பாடும் இசையானவன் ஜெகம் கூடி ஜதி பாடும் இசையானவன் எனை நாடும் தொடர்கின்ற நிழலானவன் எனை நாடும் தொடர்கின்ற நிழலானவன் நீர்தானே உயிர்க்கெல்லாம் முதலானவன் இறைவா ஒளியாகி பனியில் துணியாகும் இறையானவா நதியில் நீராகி நிலவெல்லாம் ஒளியாகி பனியில் துணியாகும் இறையானவா புவியில் திறனாகி நீரெல்லாம் கருவாகி காற்றில் அசைந்தாடும் நிறைவான ஸ்வரம் தேடியே புனை பாடினே இதம் கூடியே மகிழ்ந்தாடினே தேடும் முகமாக இதயம் கலந்தோரை ಸದ ನಿರದವ ಪರಿದವ ಸಸ ನಿರಿ ಸಸ ಸಸ ಸರಿ ಗಮರಿ ಗಸ உயிர்க்கெல்லாம் முதலானவன் நான் தேடும் உலகெல்லாம் உறவானவன் ஜெகம் கூடி ஜதி பாடும் இசையானவன் ஜெகம் கூடி ஜதி பாடும் இசையானவன் எனை நாடும் தொடர்கின்ற நிழலானவன் எனை நாடும் தொடர்கின்ற நிழலானவன் நீர்தானே உயிர்க்கெல்லாம் முதலானவன்
Today's Bible reading is taken from Psalms 37 verses 3 to 7. So trust in the Lord and do good. Live on your land and be dependable. Enjoy serving the Lord and He will give you whatever you ask for. Depend on the Lord. Trust in Him and He will help you. He will make it as clear as day that you are right. Everyone will see that you are being fair. Trust in the Lord and wait quietly for His help. Don't be angry when people make evil plans and succeed. Word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I now deem it a privilege to invite Dr. I. Annamal Arpudamary, Principal of St. Anne's Arts and Science College, who is a young and a dynamic person with lots of accolades to her name, to address the first year students in this inaugural session.
Dear beloved staff, students and parents, warm greetings to all of you from St. Anne's Arts and Science College, Madhavaram. We have gathered for the reopening of first year students with this inaugural prayer. We are indeed delighted to meet you all through online as you have joined in St. Anne's family to step into higher education. May the blessings of God give us good health of body and mind, fill us with wisdom, knowledge, courage and confidence in this new academic year. We begin this new academic year with the blessings of our beloved mother, Reverend Mother Lima Rosario, Chairman of our college. Dear students, you are aware of the ongoing crisis of Corona pandemic. All of a sudden life became different. This pandemic is having a major impact on the future of the youth because of its impacts on employment, education and the overall health system. But we need to accept the situation and behave in a responsible way. Let us believe that this situation will come to an end and we will be back to normal at the earliest. But remember that COVID-19 cannot stop our learning. We have shifted to online learning to ensure that learning continues. We are using Google Classroom digital platform for online learning. Kindly follow the instructions for online classes and do accordingly. Dear students, today you are given the opportunity for higher education. When I say opportunity, I remember the famous mathematician Albert Einstein says of opportunity. I would like to quote, "In the middle of every difficulty lies opportunity." So you need to make full use of this opportunity of stepping into higher education to succeed in life. Working together, all of us from everywhere in the world can overcome this pandemic. Dear students, we are praying for God's protection on you and your family. Our beloved mother's prayers and blessings are showered upon you. Thank you all.
St. Anne's Arts and Science College, Madhavaram, is highly fortunate to have Mother Lima Rosario, an eminent personality, as its chairperson and secretary to lead the college to greater heights with her vision and foresight, meticulous planning and execution, guidance and motivation. The college strives to sustain quality, excellence and relevance while equipping the students to meet the demands of higher education in India. The vision and mission of the Society of Sisters of St. Anne's, Chennai is well translated into action by Reverend Mother Lima Rosario, who established St. Anne's Arts and Science College in the year 2014. We owe our gratitude to our Reverend Mother for her efforts and sweat to establish this institution and for driving this institution to be an ideal one. We are ever bound to walk in her footsteps. On this note, I invite our chairperson, Reverend Mother Lima Rosario, to deliver the inaugural blessing message.
Good morning, dear students, parents, the fresh new faces. Yes, new faces. We don't know you all, but we will surely love to know you all. I would now like to welcome you all warmly as you are starting your journey with us. It's the day of happiness, joy, and welcoming too. College stands for humanism. Higher education stands for tolerance. It stands for reason, for the adventure of ideas and search for truth. It stands for the onward march of the human race toward objectives. These are the beautiful words of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru in his address to the graduates of the Allahabad University in 1947. These words focus on the formation of the character. Education is not and should not be an activity that involves only uploading information to the students, but it should be a noble mission in which character is formed, strength of the mind is increased, the intellect is expanded, and by which one can stand on one's own feet. Education is the manifestation of the perfection already in human. Ultimately, each one should work towards a social change. That change promotes a society in which peace, justice, and love rule the supreme. We, the Sisters of St. Anne, do not start the colleges for material gain, not at all. There is no need for it also. We consider always that our education is a noble mission in which the student undergo all-round formation. Here we take preferential option for the girls who hail from the marginalized section of the society. This vision we receive from our mother founders, Thattipathri Nyanamma Innaya, who founded our congregation of St. Anne. She contemplated over the situation and empathized with women of her time in 19th century who were deprived of education and thus marginalized. She discerned all her energies should be employed to dispel the darkness that enveloped the poor girls in Kilacheri village where she lived. She lit the candle of education and enlightened the women to stand the challenges of life. The most important act that our mother founders did at that time was to listen to the cry of the poor girls and to become compassionable, to form them into competent and committed people. Therefore, the education that we impart, 1. Informs the current trends and knowledge in all the fields, that is science, art and history. And this makes our students as informed people. Secondly, this information and knowledge reforms their character by exposing them to proper and appropriate social reality. Thirdly, this reformation finally forms our students into competent, committed and compassionable persons. Fourthly, this gives them a form that enables them to be employable, reliable and skillful persons. In this case, the education of St. Anne is to inform appropriate knowledge in order to reform their character, to form them as competent, committed, and compassionate persons. And finally, it gives a form of personality that is skilled, able, and noble. My dear students, I explained about ourselves. Now I want to explain to you what should be your journey with us. Student life is a beautiful life, yet hectic. It's a part of your life. Students are the backbone of the nation because you are powerful. Youth is power. As a student, the most important thing to remember is work is your best friend. Study like there is no tomorrow, because if you keep putting off your studies for tomorrow, it will be too late. Time can be your best friend depending on whether you use it or waste it. Focus on what you can do. Take a look at what you are capable of. You will feel confident and learn new things along your way. Believe in yourself. Learn new things eagerly. Explore new ideas, whatever falls on your way. Improve yourself than yesterday for tomorrow. Try to be an inspiration for yourself, and nothing else can take you down. Be an inspiration rather than looking it from others. Trust in your own instincts and life will come more in your control. Don't postpone your daily activities regarding studies. It will definitely steal your time. Let your talent shine bright. Always hold positivity in your heart and do well. Increase a very strong desire to learn. It will make you a good student to be. Try to learn from every little thing, and no one would be wiser than you. Help yourself on your own. Others will come forward to help you as well. Your preparation, efforts, hard work, and determination decides your success, nothing else. Take the oath to do daily activities every day, every morning. Some days you just have to be strong enough for yourself. Be your own sunshine. Work hard and make yourself feel worthy. Have a great day. Life is all about new opportunities and the chances it has to offer. Never let go of any opportunities and be afraid of taking new chances and choices. Success is not something easily achieved, so work hard at it and later on enjoy the rewards. Always remember, giving up is a weakness. Do it perfectly. Determination plays a huge role in our life. Always be determined on what you want and work thoroughly to reach your goal. My dear student, first of all, don't bother about how many times you fail. Secondly, you cannot stop your attempts to a venture first because you were rejected. Third, you should be ready to accept a failure of 1,009 times even. Fourth, this story inspires everyone to try hard and believe in yourself until you see success. My dear students, you have joined St. Anne's College. Who is St. Anne? What is the meaning of St. Anne's? Anne means grace, a blessing of God. Yes, you are really a blessing to your parents. Your parents are a blessing to you. Your kith and kin are a blessing to you. Now, you have joined our St. Anne's College, which is going to be a great blessing in your life. It will pour out God's graces upon you. I'm counting on you to make this year best for you with all God's blessings and graces in our college. We are here to support you every step of the way. Life is a long journey with many ups and downs in it. But I can tell you all that after completing the graduation from our institute, you will surely going to remember the value of the institute as a memorable journey of your life. As you start a new academic year now, take advantage of the many services available to help you achieve your full potential. There will be so many opportunities. I encourage you to get yourself involved, to participate in all programs available, and to take part in everything at your disposal and initiatives hosted by college throughout the year. Supporting you is central to our mission of St. Anne. We are here to guide you as you become the best version of yourself. You can really enjoy your life in our campus to be fruitful in your academics. May God bless you with all His abilities to see a bright world in your future. The ability of yours, the capability of our faculty, and the nobility of the management will be invested as a treasure to take the college to greater heights in its excellence and relevance. I wish you all the best and pray to God that all your dreams become alive and thus to be a responsible citizen of tomorrow. I love to meet you all very soon in our campus. May God bless you, my dear students, especially your parents who struggle their ways to join you in our college. A special blessings upon them all. Wish you all the best and may God bless us all. Thank you.
Let us close the inaugural session with a word of prayer. I now invite Srimati Benedict Kumari, the Dean of College Development, to close the session with a closing prayer. Heavenly Father, pray to you that we may be blessed abundantly during this present academic year amidst challenging days of COVID-19. Bless our mother, Mother Lima Rosario, to guide us in your ways, that our institution to raise to the heights. May the vision and mission of the congregation be fulfilled through our involvement in a sacrificing manner. Heavenly Father, pour out your wisdom upon our principal, deans and faculty to show the path of relevant knowledge in their guidance and teaching. We specially pray for all the parents of our institution that they may feel proud for their daughters to have been admitted to our esteemed institution. We bring before you all our office staff, supportive staff, securities and other co-workers to be blessed and filled with your protection, gift of health and wealth to carry on their lives happily. We feel that we are well protected at your bosom. We thank you for all the gifts showered upon us throughout our lives. Amen.